There's the price I pay. Destiny is calling me. Open up my eager eyes. Cause I'm Mr. Brightside.
Day in San Jose. What's up, y'all? We are at Fanime Con. The lighting is really good right now, so that's why everything is like cool. So this weekend is Fanime. We didn't get a regular Artist Alley table. We were waitlisted for the longest time, and then out of nowhere we got this email saying that they're doing something new. They're doing like an 18 and up event thing. That's part of the convention, but it's like at a hotel somewhere, like away from the convention. It comes with its own Artist Alley, its own dealer's hall. And so yeah, so we were able to get into that. Right now is day one. Yesterday was day zero. We got our badges and everything. And I'm about to go meet up with Soup. Later on today, around 6 o'clock, we're gonna go set up. And then the hours for that 18 and up thing is going to be from 8 until 2 a.m. So it's a little different. There's a shuttle that goes to and from, and we'll see how it goes. We're on our way to go set up. Soup, how you feeling, bro?
I'm all right.
Yeah, pretty excited.
No, man, just literally just woke up an hour ago and try to explore the con as much as I can. But that's about it. Now we're just getting there. Maybe I'll just explore tomorrow.
Yeah.
And not oversleep again.
Yeah. It's about 7 o'clock right now. So we got about an hour to set up. We have to go to these shuttles to the venue because it's about 10 minutes away from the actual convention. But it's supposed to be 24 hours and then at 8 o'clock, they're supposed to like double up on the shuttles.
We're vendors.
Okay, so double team, correct?
Yeah.
All right. If y'all want, you can take your stuff right here.
Yeah.
Okay, just hop on the bus.
Okay, cool. Right.
Here, let me take something for you, sir.
Nice. This nice man helping us out.
I don't know if you want to leave that around here or somewhere.
Yeah, that's okay. I'm just gonna like
pop it down.
Would you mind if I put this on? Thank you. Thank you, bro.
Yes, sir. 24% on Snapchat and it would shut down.
Excuse me. Oh shit.
The This afternoon, we want to talk about the ballot or the bullet.
The time is ticking, the seconds are non-existent. Melodic rhythms to soothe the chronic sicknesses. Put aside economic differences. This is not the genesis, maybe the revelation. The television showing demonic images. I am an immigrant, so the Abercrombie citizens want to bottle me into an awful prison system. Are you listening? Your mission is to know what your position is. I'll be gone in 60 seconds for political sentences. Bang!
What's good, y'all? It is the end of day one. Technically, the beginning of day two, because it's 6 in the morning. We've been playing video games all night and shit. Soup ran the booth by himself today, and we did pretty good. What'd you think, man?
It was a good event. I didn't really do anything besides just sitting there, but the fact that it was more than my expectation, I thought it was going to be really slow. No one was going to come to the con just because it was out of the way. But it was a good number of people. Like, the room itself was never full, but wave of people came in at like different times where, and it was also always like different people. It was never the same people walking back and forth. I mean, we had that like a couple of times, but other than that, like everybody who went to the con looked around. It wasn't much to look at, to be honest. So it was just a small room, but then they already knew what they want. So they just bought whatever they wanted and they just left.
Yeah, and I would say, like, to anybody that's thinking about doing Artist Alley, the job itself isn't very difficult, you know? Like, a lot of the times you're just sitting there and, you know, people come up to the table and then you kind of play salesman's a little bit. But even then, like, it's just a matter of if their favorite character is at your booth, whether or not they'll buy, right? So the job itself is not too hard. It's just more like tedious and keeping organized and like keeping track of like inventory and sales and things like that. Would you say?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So one thing that I actually learned this time around, like, I'm not a good salesperson. Tony does all the talking. But what I've learned is if you have that one print that catches their eye, they'll actually come and look at the rest of your stuff. Mm-hmm. So we had the Isabel Retzico one. And that caught a lot of people eye, even though we didn't put it like on the display.
Yeah.
We just sat on the table, but then that one caught their eye and they end up buying more stuff. Mm-hmm. It's because it brought them to our table, made them look at more stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's one thing I learned today. So I don't really need to play salesman. My print did that for me.
Yeah. And like, I feel like, you know, from the other conventions that we did, a lot of people were talking about like the quality of our prints too. Mm-hmm. Like they can kind of like tell that it's like it's good quality.
Yeah.
So they see that as well. And then going back to what he was saying about like catching people's eye, I think the reason why the Isabel and Red School print did very good is because it's very it hits a general audience, you know. It hits a lot of people, versus like the other things maybe kind of niche to only people that know that video game or like people that are into that type of style. The Isabel and Red School piece is very like general, right? And so that kind of like reels them in, and then once they're in, then they kind of like observe everything else. Like I said, we did really, really good day one. Only can do better day two. Like I said, right now it's 6 in the morning. We're just waiting on this complimentary breakfast at the hotel.
Hopefully it's like not where most of the people just came on day one and you know, don't want to go back day two. And hopefully there's just the people that came only for the weekend and showed up or will show up today as well, because that's what I was afraid of. Like, oh, there's a ton of people coming out right now today, but then
they're not come out tomorrow.
Yeah, it's not gonna come out tomorrow. Or are we gonna get new more or like more people tomorrow, or even like new people, or are we gonna get the same people or less?
Right. Yeah, I mean, we're just gonna have to see, you know, stuff like, cause this is the Fanime's first time doing something like this, so a lot of it is experimentation, but this is like the best day one that we've done ever. Mm-hmm. You know, I feel like it can only get better from there. Later on today, once we eat, we're gonna knock out and then wake up, count our inventory, see if we need to stock up on anything to get ready by 8 p.m. when day two starts. And then just get footage of the convention, right, when we wake up.
Yeah.
And anything else?
Well, I was just happy that this is happening during Fanime, because that artist alley looks like a college convention.
Yeah, yeah, it's small.
Yeah,
right?
It's really
small.
It's small,
but then it has the numbers of
a
big
good
convention.
Thing it was advertised well, because other than it being like a hentai night kind of thing, if it wasn't attached to Fanime, I don't think anybody would went to it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
So, good thing on that.
Yeah, and Fanime did a, I wouldn't say they did a great job, but they did a pretty alright job as far as shuttles to get to and from the convention center to the hotel where we were at. There was like two shuttle services. But even then, like, the lines were still packed. Like, people were waiting outside in the cold for a good amount of time waiting for the buses. So I don't know if that affected anything. But they, you know, for what it's worth, they did their best, you know. And it wasn't it wasn't too bad. Like, I waited like a good, when I left, I waited like a good 20 minutes outside before I got on the show.
Yeah, like I said, I know, like, some people, like my friends, they'll just say like, oh, okay, I'm interested in hentai, but then they're not gonna go every day. They're just gonna go one time.
Yeah.
And then just to experience, and the rest of the other days, they're not gonna go.
Yeah.
So I'm just scared that might be the thinking of a lot of people. Just go one time to experience it. And then the other days, oh, we already went that one day, why need to go again?
Right.
Because what else is there more to see than just whatever they're showing there? Like, I don't even know.
Yeah, yeah.
I've never been to hentai place, so I'm assuming they just show like random hentais, or I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, there are other events there, like K-pop.
There's K-pop stuff.
Stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But
so maybe I'll be wrong, man. Like, it brings different audience, different days.
Yeah. But all in all, like, even for one day, this matched SoCal Retro Gaming Expo, and that was a 2-day con, and that was like randomly our best convention so far. But it matched that in one day.
Yeah.
So yeah. So yeah. So that's about it. We'll see what's up tomorrow.
Hell yeah.
And,
oh, shit. Ooh.
Yeah.
Y'all doing this vlog?
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh, what's
this? A man.
Y'all talking?
Android.
What's up,
I am
man?
Exclusive.
Y'all doing this thing?
It's kind of on one. But, go follow him. And then we got my man, Sly.
Ooh.
401 Feezy.
Ooh, y'all doing DMs one time.
Check out,
my hand.
Check out
go
his Funny Fridays.
Same Funny Fridays.
Stupid Ark, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Go follow them, bro. They made sales today, dog.
Yeah.
All lights, man, your station.
What's up, y'all? So it is day 3. Oh shit. It's day 3 of the convention. I wasn't able to capture any footage of day 2 because there was no more space on my phone. But after clearing it out, you know, now we're doing all of the video stuff today. Yesterday was pretty good. Yeah, what'd you think about yesterday? Soup worked most of the time at the booth yesterday. What were your thoughts?
It was, well, we expected it to be good, but then I didn't know it was going to be that good, you know? Just like how the first day was, this one kind of exceeded my expectation. It was kind of hard because I was getting sick at the same time, so luckily I had my other cousin there.
Yeah, shout out to Steve for coming through. And like, you know, taking us out to eat and shit, and then helping out at the booth.
Yeah, unlike yesterday, or not yesterday, I'm sorry. Unlike Friday, where it was coming in waves and everybody was just going in and get it out. On Saturday, the little room was actually packed. So that was also good. Other than that, everything went well. I had to call Tony in the last 2 hours to cover me just because I need to take a break. Hopefully we could get at least half or whatever. Sunday even more, or maybe even more. But
yeah, I feel pretty confident about Sunday, just because that's kind of like the day that people, their last minute buying, you know, they kind of hold everything off until Sunday, And so we sold out on a lot of prints yesterday. We sold out on like 4 different prints, and so we had to stock up a lot. If there's anything that I learned from this time around, is that we have to, like the big shows like Fanime, Anime Expo, Silicon Valley Comic Con, we're gonna have to like stock up in a way that we don't usually stock up for regular shows. You know, we're gonna have to like overstock. And what Supa's saying was, we're probably just gonna start buying shit in like bulk, you know, and just like leaving it at the house and like taking however much you need for that convention, you know, buying it in packs of 100 or whatever. And then, but yeah, like Fanime so far has really exceeded our expectations for sure. Cause we thought, or at least I thought that it was gonna be like a flop because it was so out of the way. But they did a pretty good job when it came to like the shuttles and trying to be organized and stuff like that.
We were basically thinking about all the possible ways that it could have went wrong. As in, oh yeah, the DoubleTree is 9 minutes away. Why would they want to go out all the way out there at the middle of the night or at 2 a.m. in the morning or whatever? And yeah, it just shows how much like love the fandom has, where it's like, we like this. We like this convention, we're gonna go out to like experience everything.
Yeah.
And that's what it is. And I mean, I don't know why I doubt it. I myself is like that, where I'm just nocturnal. I'm gonna do anything I want at night, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Or
yeah,
as much as I can at night. So I don't know why I doubt it, other anime fans.
Yeah, right. We're all kind of the same. Like these past couple days, like I haven't really been sleeping that much. We've literally been in the game room from after the convention, after our booth time is over, so at 2 a.m. until 8 in the morning every day, just so that way we can get the free breakfast at the hotel. So we would just be playing video games from 3 a.m. to 8 a.m. and then eat and then go to sleep and then wake up around like 2 p.m., do the same shit the next day. So it's been a pretty good convention. It's very tiring and exhausting for sure. But, you know, all in all, it's good. So today, we're gonna just capture as much footage as we can. And then hopefully I can get some footage of the actual hentai section, like the R18 hentai section. Show you guys how big the line is for the shuttle. Like, it gets pretty packed. Like, Soup had to wait like an hour just to get back to the hotel from the R18 section, right? Yeah.
That's really bad.
Yeah, so that's about it. We'll keep you guys posted. Anything else you want to say?
Not really.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's basically not much to do at night.
Yeah.
There's the rave. People do random shit in the middle of the convention center.
Yeah.
And then there's the hentai night. Yeah, you know, some people aren't about that rave life.
Right, right.
So they'll just head over to the DoubleTree, and that's where we get most of our stuff. Like, I wasn't expecting people to want to take their time out. I mean, luckily the fucking shuttle was free, because I thought it was a paid shuttle myself.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, I didn't know.
Yeah, that'd be fucked up.
I didn't know they hired people to take people here and there. Mm. But yeah, hopefully today's a good show. I want to at least make a little bit more than half of what we made yesterday, just so it could pay for our prints back from FedEx.
Oh yeah, so what happened was, since we sold out of a lot of stuff last night, we had to go to, it was UPS. So yeah, there's a UPS connected to the convention center. So super convenient, you know, you just walk there. But then to order 40, 45 prints was close to $400, you know, just for that. Just for the restock, and like they fucked up on the order. They didn't make it like full bleed or whatever. The quality of the paper is not as nice. So these are things to like keep in mind if you're gonna come to a convention of this caliber, is to like really, really make sure that your stock is good, you know? But it's like kind of hard because all the artists are doing it. Like when I was at the UPS, they had like a line of just artists restocking because, you know, Fanime this year turned out really good. And I think it's because it's an anniversary too. It's like 15 year anniversary type shit. So yeah, so there's a lot of people that came out. But yeah, anyways, we'll keep you guys posted maybe later on tonight to see how day 3 goes. Today's the last night of selling. And then tomorrow, usually Monday, there's really not that much going on. And so yeah. That's a wrap for Fanime. Last night was the last night of selling our prints at the R18 section of Fanime. We did pretty good, not as well as the first 2 days, but not bad for a single day, for a Sunday. What do you think about it, Sue?
Well, that Sunday sold more than other cons for like 2 day cons and 1 day cons, so it was still good.
Yeah.
If we had to put that in our, like, what's the most we sold in a single day con?
In 1 day?
Yeah.
I think it was like Anifest.
Was like what? 800?
Like seven something.
Yeah, so.
For 1 day.
That 1 day on Sunday, even though it was slow, it's still on par with a 1 day convention for us at least.
Yeah. Yeah, but that was the last day too. So it was, yeah. I just realized right now that I didn't really get footage of like the actual booth or like, you know, being at the artist alley. It was just more Fanime footage. It's really hard because there's so much going on.
So much going on. It's usually crowded. We always have that situation where Tony wants to go dance. I was sick as fuck. So it was, at times it wasn't both of us at the booth. It was always at least one of us at the booth. And sometimes I would have my friends be there as well.
Yeah.
But other than that, yeah, it's hard just to get footage. That's why we need a cameraman or at least a friend to like do it for us.
Yeah, somebody that likes doing that type of shit. Because it's so like, for me, it's really hard to like be in the moment of doing something and then stop to take out my camera and to like, you know, capture some stuff. Sometimes I don't get it in time. Like if I see something interesting and I do think about busting out the camera to record, like 9 times out of 10 the event passed already. So that's always been a dilemma. But you know, a lot of this vlog I feel like is just gonna be showing you what anime or what Fanime looks like. And then just kind of just giving you reviews of like what's been happening as far as the artist alley part goes. Yeah.
But yeah, overall, the like we said it before, it exceeded our expectation, or the night market, whatever you want to call it. There was a little hiccup at the end about packing up.
Oh my god.
We're actually gonna go back and pick up something we forgot, but so what happened was, the lady that was supervising the artist alley for this convention, she usually emailed everybody, but then I'm not sure when she sent this one email telling us or asking us when do we want to pack up, because people usually pack up after,
after
the day is finished or the last day is finished. But for some reason, we had to sign up to pack up that night.
Yeah, yeah. They expected us to pack up today, the day after.
Yeah, so I don't understand what that is, or maybe it has. I felt like, or I think I heard she said something. It has to do with something with the hotel itself.
Yeah, but I think what it was is, so the artist alley ended at 2 in the morning, and I think they only had the room rented out until 3. So they wanted us to be gone by 3. So I think, like, they only wanted, you know, people that, or they wanted a head count of, like, people that can pack up within that hour, or if not, just pack up the next day. But then what was, like, kind of weird about it was she was like, I don't know, the vibe was, if we didn't sign up to pack up that night, we couldn't pack up or something like that.
Yeah.
Like, it's stupid.
Then we just made the joke that, oh yeah, we're going to be blacklisted from Fanime because we didn't follow the rules.
Yeah, no. And like, we asked other artists around and like, they didn't really give a fuck either. Like, they pack up when they pack up. Some chose to pack up last night, especially the ones that like had a more simple setup and they could pack up real fast. And then some chose to pack up today. And so I think, like, you know,
you gotta understand, some people aren't like on top of their email games like us.
Yeah.
And we don't check it every single day or every single minute.
Yeah, but honestly, I don't think it's big of a.
Yeah, it's not that big of a deal.
I think it's just that lady.
I feel like it's just probably they don't want to get in trouble themselves, you know.
Yeah.
So maybe has to do with that.
Yeah, and it was the first time too. So like. So since they don't have like enough experience to know how the timing of things would be, they kind of were like trying to be strict about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Other than that, like, it was not a bad convention at all. Like, what was cool about it was, brought its own niche. Actually, yeah, you want to continue this later and then just go get it?
Yes. You want to get some bofa?
Some what?
Bofa.
What's that?
Bofa these nuts!
Oh my god. Fuck out of here.
He's...
Man.